Good afternoon and welcome to St. Ambrose. Our opening song tonight is 467, I Heard the Voice of Jesus, number 464. That's not what I said. It really is number 464.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
I came to Jesus, and I found in him my life. As we prepare our hearts to celebrate the wondrous mystery of God's love for us and his beloved Son, Jesus, let us acknowledge our sometimes lackadaisical approach or failure to approach our Lord Jesus. Let us come to him now with humble hearts and ask forgiveness and new fervor, new love. Lord Jesus, gentle shepherd, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord Jesus, guide of our life, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus, our hope, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you.
We give you thanks for your great glory.
Lord God, heavenly King,
O God, almighty Father,
Lord Jesus Christ,
only Son,
Lord God, Lamb of God,
Son of the Father,
you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father.
Have mercy on us.
For you alone are the Holy One.
You alone are the Lord.
You alone are the Most High,
Jesus Christ,
with the Holy Spirit,
and the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Let us pray. Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, we may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Woe to the shepherds who mislead and scatter the flock of my pasture, says the Lord. Therefore, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, against the shepherds who shepherd my people, you have scattered my sheep and driven them away. You have not cared for them, but I will take care to punish your evil deeds. I myself will gather the remnant of my flock from all the lands to which I have driven them and bring them back to their meadow. There they shall increase and multiply. I will appoint shepherds for them who will shepherd them so that they need no longer fear and tremble, and none shall be missing, says the Lord. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up a righteous shoot to David. As king, he shall reign and govern wisely. He shall do what is just and right in the land. In his days, Judah shall be saved. Israel shall dwell in security. This is the name they give him, the Lord our justice. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, in Christ Jesus, you who once were far off have become near by the blood of Christ. For he is our peace, he who made both one and broke down the dividing wall of enmity through his flesh, abolishing the law with his commandments and legal claims, that he might create in himself one new person in place of the two, thus establishing peace, and might reconcile both with God in one body through the cross, putting that enmity to death by it. He came and preached peace to you who were far off, and peace to those who were near. For through him, we both have access in one spirit to the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
The apostles gathered together with Jesus and reported all they had done and taught. He said to them, "Come away by yourselves to a deserted place and rest for a while." People were coming and going in great numbers, and they had no opportunity even to eat. So they went off in the boat by themselves to a deserted place. People saw them leaving, and many came to know about it. They hastened there on foot from all the towns and arrived at the place before them. When he disembarked and saw the vast crowd, his heart was moved with pity for them, for they were like sheep without a shepherd, and he began to teach them many things. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Us reflect today on this theme, sheep without a shepherd. Now, just taking you back to last week, you remember about the calling and the sending of the apostles to go out and preach the good news. And I remember summarizing in three words: called, empowered, and sent. So, and off they went. Now, this Sunday, they come back full of experiences and excitement. Now this experience of the disciples coming back with their experiences kind of reminds me of my life during my seminary studies. Now, during the last 4 years of our seminary formation, every long holiday, what we'd call here summer vacation, would be sent as soon as we closed the seminary and come home, would be assigned to a different parish for pastoral experience. Now, during that period of 3 months, you report to the parish, and then you are not to stay, just to live in the rectory there. So we arrive there, and then we have a program set for us. So we were sent two by two. So the parish where we are sent, the priest already has a program for us, and the program was to send the seminarians out to the people. So we actually spend time with the people, living with them. So we were living 1 week at a time in every village. So living with them, eating what they have to eat, to provide, and teaching them. So we would visit every home, spend time with them. Then in the evening, we would gather for the small Christian community and share the do something like a Lectio Divina, then go through the scriptures and have a moment of sharing. So it was very fruitful, and it was a very nice experience. Now at the end of the 3 months, we all gather at the diocese. We had a pastoral center there. We all gather there, all the seminarians, together with the bishop and the vocations director. Then we have some time together for a couple of days. And during that time, the seminarians would kind of report how the experience was, whatever parish you had been assigned to. And it was very exciting to hear from all the vast experiences. Some of them had a very nice welcome in some homes, others not so much. Others were well fed, others were not so well fed. Others had slept in a bed with bed bugs. So all those experiences, but the best one of all was how the people, they were able to bring so many people back to the church, to the faith. So that was where the excitement was. Bringing back so many people, even those who had kind of fallen back. And we looked forward to the following year to be sent out again. This is the same kind of experience that the apostles are having. They went out, they were quite successful. Now they have come back full of excitement. They would like to share their successes, how the mission had been, and maybe receive some appreciation from Jesus. Good job, well done. And also anticipate for another assignment. Just imagine driving out demons. So they come back, and now they are excited to share with Jesus, and Jesus invites them to a deserted place. So my dear sisters and brothers, we see people from towns and all over Galilee, they are coming around. They want to see Jesus, to hear from Jesus, that they even didn't have that time anymore. And his heart was moved because he looked at the people and they appeared like sheep without a shepherd. Jesus is that shepherd. Jesus is our shepherd. He has drawn us here today from different households, from different families, perhaps even from different towns. We have come here together to celebrate the Eucharist, this wonderful sacrament that Jesus established to be celebrated in his name until the end of time. This sacrament in which we receive our Lord, our Redeemer, our Shepherd. Now, going back to the Gospel reading, his disciples had come back from preaching and healing and driving out demons. Then Jesus wants to have time with them alone. But there were so many people around that they couldn't find any time to talk about what had happened. In my thinking, I think they grabbed some bread and some fish and took off to a deserted place to have some leisurely meal, get reacquainted after their time of separation, just to be together for a while. They tried to get away for some privacy. That wasn't very successful. And we will hear more about that in the Gospels for the next few weeks. I want to bring that experience now back here. Every time we come for Mass, and at the end of Mass, we are commissioned to go. Go forth in peace, proclaiming the gospel by your lives. We are being sent out. Then the following week, as we come, it is like that time the disciples head after their mission. We come here after a week of fulfilling our various responsibilities, bringing our flaws and successes, our disappointments and joys, our anguish and hope. Then Jesus says, "Come and be with me." And we have time to hear what he has to say to us through the word of God. Then we have the leisure, not the rush, to share a meal. And then we have some quiet time to be together in a profound communion, an incredible intimacy with him and our fellow disciples, a time that allows us to reflect on what he has said and done. A time for him to break down our divisions, a time to be encouraged and challenged, a time to feel his support before we are sent out again in his name. This is one of our special times to be with him before we go out and do what he asks us to do. So we come. We be with him, with all that communion, before again, at the end of Mass, we say, "Go in peace, proclaiming the gospel by your lives." So we'll be sent again, go and continue the mission, and then come back again to spend time with the Lord. So I would like to challenge each of you today that maybe in the course of the week, try to create some time, just a quiet time. Remember, Jesus says, let's go to a quiet place. Just create some quiet time, just to be with the Lord in communion, to hear what the Lord has to say to you, to soak in the graces which the Lord is giving you, to be empowered for the mission. May we always treasure the time we have with the Lord. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let's stand now. And in a spirit of prayer, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let's offer our prayers and petitions now with confidence in God.
For bishops, may God guide them in their work as shepherds for the many people they serve. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who lead our communities, may God's justice illuminate their decisions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faith community and our efforts to be attentive to the needs around us, may God show us where he calls us to serve. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in the light of Christ, may God bring them to eternal peace with him. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our book of intentions and those calling and requesting prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sister diocese in Ledwar, Kenya, and our sister parish in Guatemala, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our St. Ambrose Parish family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Jane Kavanaugh, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Now let us call upon our Blessed Mother and her intercession as we say, Hail
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We pray through Christ our Lord.
My Savior, I shall Only in God is my soul at rest. In Him comes my salvation. He only is my rock, my strength, and my salvation.
O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Blessed is he.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat his bread and drink his cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Joseph, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him,
O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command and formed by Jesus' own divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer one another some sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Body of Christ.
Thank you.
Our communion song is number 478, Fly Like a Bird. 478.
To the Lord, my soul, I want to soar.
This week is your last chance to register to play in the St. Ambrose 3rd Annual Golf Tournament. Come play, have lunch, and have fun with our priests and fellow parishioners. Registration forms are in the vestibule, and the weather forecast calls for a beautiful day for next Saturday's event. On Saturday, August 10th, we will be having a dual celebration in the Parish Activity Center. We will be celebrating Bishop Edward M. Losey's first anniversary as the fifth bishop of the Diocese of Kalamazoo and the installation of Father Albert as pastor of St. Ambrose Parish. So that we can make plans for the food for this dual celebration, there are sign-up sheets in the vestibule of the church. We are also asking for you to help with food preparation and serving. There are additional sign-up sheets if you would like to assist us. All are invited to attend the Mass and reception following. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So, just as a follow-up, to prepare enough food for everyone without wasting, we would like to know if you'll be able to attend the reception. There's a sign-up sheet there. And also, if you'd like to volunteer to help in preparing the things and setting up for the day, there's also a sign-up sheet there. And then also, if you'd like to write a note, we have some cards over there. So feel free to pick some cards for yourself to write a note. This, I think it will to make the day colorful. You have something to add?
Colorful, that's good.
Yes.
We actually, we're lucking out pretty good. Father Albert is a pretty good pastor, and Bishop Losey's a pretty good bishop. And so we're lucking out pretty good.
It's only one chance. I'll be off to the next station after 5 years.
Let's stand and pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
In peace, let us go to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing song is number 534, Peace is Flowing Like a River. 5, 3, 4.